哈利路亚，奉耶稣圣名正道。
In the name of the Lord Jesus, I speak.
靠着圣灵的帮助，
By the help of the Holy Spirit,
我们继续来分享、来查考《使徒行传》。
We continue to study and share on the Acts of the Apostles.
我们之前共用了八堂的道理来分享的第一章跟第二章。
Previously, we made use of eight sessions of sermons to share on the Acts of the Apostles, chapter 1.
第一章的题目叫做“荣耀教会的预备”。
The theme of chapter 1 is the preparation of the glorious church.
我们在里面看到了有五种的预备。
And in there, we can see five types of preparation.
那么第二章，我们看到荣耀教会的诞生、产生。
In chapter 2, we can see that the birth of the glorious church.
那么给我们一个很重要的真理，就是教会的建立是靠圣灵，圣灵降临才开始建立教会。
It provides us with a very important truth that the church is established by the Holy Spirit.
这是非常重要的一个真理，一个启示。
It is a very, very important revelation and the truth.
那么我们用了四堂哦来讲第二章，特别有关圣灵的见证，圣灵的这些作为。
We made use of four sermons to share about the important works of the Holy Spirit.
今天我们用另外一个程度。重新再看这个第一章跟第二章，另一个角度。
And today we'll take from a different perspective to review chapters 1 and 2.
就是从使徒行传来看教会的危机。
That to look at the crisis for the church from the Acts of the Apostles.
教会的危机也就是信仰的危机。
The crisis of the church is also the crisis of our faith.
那么信仰呢，有分团体的信仰，也有分个人的信仰。
In terms of faith, it is also being divided into the faith of the individual and the faith of the group.
我们会从一章 到第七章到第八章里面 都看教会危机，你会看到自己的信仰，看到我们自己的教会。
From chapters 1 to 8, we'll be able to see the crisis of our faith and the crisis of the church.
我们是透过使徒教会的一些问题，一些危机，来检讨我们今天的危机，要如何去解决这种危机。
By examining the crisis of the apostolic church, we review the faith and the state of our church today.
好，我们看第一章的危机在哪里。
Let's look at the crisis of the first chapter.
第一章的危机就是从第九节到十一节。
The crisis of the first chapter can be found from verses 9 to 11.
来，我们一起读圣经第一章的第九节。
Chapter 1, verse 9.
一、二、三。说了这话，他们正看的时候，他就被起上身，有一朵云彩把他借起，便看不见他了。当他往上去，他们定睛望天的时候，突然有两个人身穿白衣站在旁边说，加利利人啊，你们为什么站坐望天呢？离开你们被借升天的耶稣，你们见他怎样往天上去，他还要怎样来。这里你看到说危机在哪里？危机是哪里？什么危机？
From this passage, what kind of crisis can you observe?
我们在这里看到就是站坐的危机，站坐的危机。
Now we can see this crisis of just standing.
这里说当主耶稣被借升天的时候，这些门徒啊都站在那边看着主耶稣升天。
Here it states that when the Lord Jesus was taken up, the disciples were standing there gazing up into heaven.
这是一个很属灵的意象，属灵的情景。
This been a very spiritual vision.
从来都没有看过这样的事情。
It's something that they have never seen before.
亲眼看到主耶稣被借升天，谁看过呀？
Who has witnessed the ascension of the Lord Jesus into heaven with their eyes?
我相信他们当时的心是非常惊讶，非常惊讶的。
Surely they were very bewildered, very shocked.
甚至也有陶醉在这种属灵的境界里面，属灵的意象里面。
So much so that they were probably enjoying in this vision.
或者还是已经麻木了，在那边不知道做什么，在那边发呆了，不懂得做什么。
They were probably also feeling numb and not knowing what to do next.
总之我们不清楚他们当时的心态，他们的状况怎样。
And they were not clear with their state of mind and what should they do next.
总之他们就站在那边，什么都没有做，什么都没有动，就是站在那边看。
ultimately, all that they were doing were just standing there, gazing up to heaven and doing nothing else.
那么要怎样来解决这个站坐的危机呢？
So how do we resolve this crisis of just standing?
请注意，站坐就是什么都没有做，没有动，什么都没有动，什么都没有做。
Take note that when you are just standing, you are doing nothing else.
其实主耶稣有告诉他们要做什么的，主耶稣有吩咐，有告诉，有提醒了的。
But the Lord Jesus had already given his instruction and a reminder as to what they are supposed to do next.
可是他们就还是站在那边呢。
But they were just standing right there doing nothing.
我们看怎样解决这个站坐的危机。
Let's look at how we should resolve this crisis of just standing.
神就差派天使来提醒他们，来警告他们。
And behold, two men stood by them in white apparel to give them warning.
那么这是天使提出一个问题来问他们。
And the angel asked them,
加利利人啊，你们为什么站坐望天呢？
Men of Galilee, why do you stand gazing up into heaven?
这个是一个要我们去反省的问题。为什么我站在这里？我为什么站在这里一直看一直看？为什么？
Now it is a very important question for us to self-reflect on why are we standing here and looking up to heaven?
有时我们不会这样问自己，我们也不知道要这样来问自己。
Very often we fail to ask ourselves this question.
所以需要天使来提醒，需要一个人来提醒我们，来问我们。
We need someone else. We need the angel to remind us to ask us this question.
这样我们就会去思考，我们就会去回答。
Only then we're able to ponder over it and think about our answer.
当天使问了这个问题过后呢，天使也解释为什么不要再妄作妄天，他也有解释，天使也有解释。
After the angel asked this question, he also went on to explain, what are you to do next?
那天使的解释是什么？
What was the angel's explanation?
今天信徒会问啊，我为什么不可以站在万天？我为什么不可以站在这里？我为什么一定要听你？我为什么我有我的自由，我有我的权利啊，我站在这里啊。
Just like our members today will ask you, I have my own freedom and I have my liberty to stand here and to do my thing.
为什么你们教会这样讲，我一定要做的吗？我们教会这样讲，我们一定要跟的吗？我们有我们的自由呀。
I have my freedom and I have my liberty. Why should I comply with every instruction of the church?
你可以给很多理由不顺服。
You can have a lot of excuses not to comply and obey.
你可以给很多理由继续的站在那边。
You can have a lot of reasons to continue standing there doing nothing.
但你看天使怎么样解释？
But what did the angel say?
你们这个离开你们被借升天的耶稣，你们看他怎样往天上去。他还要怎样来？
The same Jesus who was taken up from you into heaven will so come in like manner as you saw him go into heaven.
这个就是为什么我们不可以再站坐望天的真正的理由。
This is the real reason why you cannot just stand there and gaze up to heaven.
那么你看主耶稣怎样往天上去是吗？他来的时候是怎样来的？他来的时候是怎样来的？
Now you see how the Lord Jesus was taken up to heaven, and it will also be the same way that he will come from heaven.
天使说他怎样上去，他就是怎样来，是一样，怎样上去就怎样下来。
In the same manner he went up, the same manner he will also come down.
所以说他是被一朵云彩借上去的。
He was taken up in cloud.
云彩在圣经里面是神的荣耀，神驾着他的荣耀上去，带着他的荣耀上去，主耶稣带着他的荣耀上去。
These clouds are also the analogy of the glory of God and by which Jesus was taken up in the glory of God.
那圣经 也启示我们说，将来主耶稣来的时候呢，也是驾坐云来的，驾坐那个云这样下来的。
The Bible also reveals to us that in the second coming of the Lord Jesus, he is also coming down in the clouds.
那时就跟这里有一点点不一样。
And at that time, it will be slightly different from the description here.
因为这里主耶稣上去的时候是他一个人上去。
Because now the Lord Jesus is taken up to heaven alone.
他来的时候不是一个人啊，他是带着千千万万天使。圣经说，所有的众天使，所有的天使一起来。
But at his second coming, he will not be alone anymore. He will be coming down with the hosts of heaven and all angels.
你想所有的天使多可怕呀，多少天使啊，那个场面是多大，多荣耀呀。
You can imagine what a glorious scene it will make with all the hosts of the heaven and also the angels coming with the Lord Jesus.
我们看到一位天使，两位天使都已经很惊讶，都不得了了。
But for you to be looking at one or two angels, you'll be shocked.
你看到千千万万天使的时候，那个场面怎么样？
So you can only imagine what you will react, how you react when you see billions and billions of angels.
那还有呢？他除了带天使，还带谁来？你知道吗？
So who else would the Lord Jesus bring along?
哦，圣经预言说，他还要带着那些已经去世了的信徒，那些圣徒在乐园那边等候的那些死去的信徒一同带来，跟天使一起来啊，来迎接我们。
Now the Bible prophesizes that the Lord Jesus will also be bringing the saints who have died in Christ to receive us.
所以，亲爱的弟兄姐妹
，Dear brothers and sisters，
我们不要再站坐望天了啦。
Do not stand and gaze up to heaven no more.
我们今天教会的情形，我们个人的信仰还是教会的情形，都是多大部分都站坐望天，在那边站坐，什么都不做，什么都不动。
This is actually the state of our faith today, that we are just standing there and doing nothing else.
是啊，他们没有离开主啊，他们还在教会啊。
And it is true that they have not departed from the church.
好像这些门徒也没有离开主，还是看作主升天啊，都没有离开主啊，没有错啊。
So did the disciples here, they did not depart from the Lord Jesus.
可是他们也什么都没有做呀。
But neither did they do anything else.
最重要是主耶稣吩咐他们的，要回耶路撒冷去。要在那边等候，要用那边祷告，他们没有做啊，他们没有回耶路撒冷，他们没有照耶稣的吩咐来去做。
Because the Lord Jesus had already instructed them to depart to Jerusalem and wait for him.
那么听到了天使的警告跟提醒，门徒他怎么样反应？他们的动作是什么
？But it is only after the warning and the reminder of the angels. So how did the disciples react?
那十二节
，Verse 12。
来，我们一起读十二节。
Verse 12.
有一座山名叫橄榄山，离耶路撒冷不远，便有安息日可走的路程。当下，请注意，当下就是马上，门徒从那里回耶路撒冷去，听了天使的警告啊、哦、跟提醒，他们马上回耶路撒冷。
It is said that then they returned to Jerusalem immediately.
这就解决了，天使就帮门徒们解决了他们站坐的危机，这个危机就解除了。
So after the warning and the reminder from the angel, this crisis of waiting has been resolved.
那么从这个危机，我们来思考三个问题。
From this crisis, we can ponder over three questions.
第一
，First，
今天我们教会或者你个人是否重视从天上来的提醒
？Do you and the church, do you personally and the church emphasize on the reminder from heaven?
天使的提醒就是从天上来的。
The reminder of the angel refers to the reminder from heaven.
今天不是没有从天上来的提醒，是很多人没有去珍惜，没有去珍惜看重这个天上来的提醒。
It is not that there is no reminder from heaven today, but that people do not cherish and do not appreciate the reminders from heaven.
人常常透过圣经啊，透过讲道啊，提醒我们，这些都是从天上来的声音。
These reminders are coming in the form of the voices of the sermons at a church.
那有时是透过圣灵的感动啊，圣灵的工作啊，不断的提醒我们呀。
Sometimes it is also through the works of the Holy Spirit, and you are moved by the Holy Spirit, and this comes as a form of reminder to you.
这是第一个问题。
That is the first question for you.
教会是否有重视从天上来的提醒
？Has the church emphasized on the reminder from heaven?
第二个问题。
Secondly,
今天的教会是否常常有做自我反省、自我检讨的这种动作
？Has the church today, frequently reflected on ourselves?
特别是我们带领教会的长老、执事、传道人
，especially the leaders and the ministers of the church，
还有我们的 CMC 那些成员、那些负责人
，and the committee members of the church。
我们是否有常常做自我反省
？Have we
听个警告，常常做自我的反省？
Have we, after listening to the warning and the reminder, examined ourselves?
我是不是在这里站坐望天
？Or am I just standing here gazing up to heaven?
那第三个问题。
The third question.
那今日的教会是否有当下的行动？就是是否有马上这种行动
？For the church, in the church today, do we take immediate action?
我们很会开会，我们真耶稣教会真的很会开会。
We are very good at conducting meetings.
我们常常都在开会，时刻时时常常都在开会。
We are always conducting meetings and going in and out of meetings.
开会是好的，开会是正确的，开会是需要的呀。
Indeed, having a meeting is necessary.
开会就是要解决问题嘛，开会就是要做工嘛，对不对？
You want to conduct a meeting so that you can resolve a problem and get ready to do some action.
你看我们开了多少次的会，重复又重复，前提议案又前提议案，然后有了议决，有些是没有议决，有了议决也没有行动，也没有去处理。
But you can take a look for yourself. How many meetings have we gone through and how much action have we not taken?
然后又第二次又来开会了，又重复前面的前提议案，又重复，不断的重复。
And you go on to another meeting and you continue to raise the cases in before.
很多时候我们开会本来在开会的时候在闲聊了，就在聊很多东西了，好像是在开会了，其实已经没有重点了，就是在聊天间。 这个是我们要提出检讨的事情来的，我们开会的人要提出检讨的事情。
And this is definitely something for us to raise up to examine ourselves on.
所以我们一直在开会啊，一直听到有开会，一直都讲很忙呀。
We are always going in and out of meetings, and we are making ourselves so busy.
就是缺少了门徒这里当下的行动，就是马上。
And this shows that we are also lacking in the immediate action which the disciples are showing.
或者有一些同工，有一些圣工人员有这样的行动，但是大部分可能没有。
Perhaps some divine workers or some people do have this behavior, but most of us simply don't.
这个又回到如果没有行动的时候，没有马上行动，又回到暂坐望天、暂坐的危机了。
If you are not taking an immediate action, then you are just standing and gazing up to heaven.
好，我们看第二种危机。
We look at a second type of crisis.
我们看十三节到十四节。
We look at verse 13 to verse 14.
来，一二三，进了城，就上了所住的一间楼房，在那里有彼得、约翰、雅各、安德烈、菲利、多马、巴多罗买、马太、亚勒菲的儿子雅各、奋罪党的西门和雅各的儿子犹大。十四节，这些人同坐几个妇人和耶稣的母亲玛利亚，并耶稣的弟兄，都同心合意的。恒切祷告，这里我们看到什么呢
？What do you see here？
我们看到这里没有危机，没有危机。
You may see there's no crisis here。
没有危机，那传道到底要讲什么呢
？So what does the preacher want to say about this？
这个就是我要讲的了。
This is what I want to say。
这里我们看到哈，11使徒哦，全部在一起，
That all 11 disciples have been gathered together。
还有几个妇人。
And a few women.
还加上主耶稣的妈妈，还有主耶稣的弟弟们，兄弟们。
Together with the brothers and the mother of Jesus.
我们都看到主耶稣的兄弟哈，都信主耶稣了，接受主耶稣了。
Now we can see that the brothers of Jesus have finally accepted Jesus and believed.
他们这里说都同心合意的恒切祷告。
Here it tells us that they have been gathered together in one mind to pray.
这绝对没有危机。
There should be no crisis here.
有同心当然没有危机了。
Since they have been in one accord, there should be no crisis.
我要讲的危机就是我们今天的教会，我们就是因为没有同心，没有像他们这样同心合意、恒切祷告，缺少这种同心祷告，所以变成危机处处、危机的存在。
Which is why I would like to raise to all of you that the reason why our church is beset with all kinds of crises is because we do not pray with supplication and one accord.
如果有一天我们大家都好像这里这样，门徒他们这样，弟兄姐妹，耶稣的家庭这样，都同心，大家的心都一样，敬拜真神，相信主耶稣，然后一起努力教会，那当然没问题啊，危机就解除了。
If there is one fine day where all of us will be gathered together with our family members, with all our brothers and sisters, in one accord in prayer and supplication, then a lot of our crises will be resolved.
我今天看教会哦，真的没有同心。
But I look at the church today, we do not have one accord.
所以我们没有力量啊，我们做什么要做什么都很困难，很困难，非常困难。
Which is why we are powerless. There is nothing that we can do, and a lot of obstacles that come in our way.
无论是对真理的看法，还是对不是真理的一些事情，我们都很多很多的意见，很难在一起有一个共识，很难。
whether in our study of the truth and in our opinions, it is very hard for us to come in one mind.
以前我们的真理就是大家 一定是一样的呀、啊，没有说不一样的、啊，因为真理就是一样啊。但我跟你讲，今天你在研究真理的时候，很多不一样，已经讲不通了的。你两个人讲不通了的，在吵架而已。
In the past, we always talk. We always have the one absolute truth which all of us will agree on. But today, if you go into a research of the truth, people will always end up in arguments.
啊，有些人哦，为了不要吵、不要冲突，他静静不代表他同意你，知道吗？他根本不甩你，也不用再讲，他不需要跟你讲，他静静。
There are also some people who would rather stay quiet and not to end up in any conflict, any arguments, but doesn't mean that they agree or they disagree.
你想长时间这样，常年这样几好几年、十年这样，有同心吗？心有在一起吗？连真理的事情上都没有，都不一样，怎样同工呀？怎样说神同在呀？
Imagine that.The situation continue to happen for the next longer term, then how do you expect the heart of Jesus to be with us?
还有很多很多的事情。
There are many other things to consider.
就算是对付魔鬼哦，去赶鬼，对付魔鬼都有不同的见解，不同的讲法，不同的做法，不同的看法，没有办法同心，怎样赶鬼呀？
Even in our approach to resist the devil, and there are already a lot of arguments and differing opinions about this.
我们这个不同心哦，在我们教是蛮严重的呀，已经影响到我们的这种成长，也影响到我们啊主耶稣的荣耀，主耶稣的圣功。
The disharmony and the disunity in the church today have seriously and severely impacted the work of the church today.
这个就是教会的地。这里地上的第二个危机了，但是这里是没有危机，但我们今天却有这个危机。
And this is the second crisis that can reflect on our church today. Although it doesn't show the crisis here, but this is also the lack of it that causes our crisis today.
好，我们从第一章再看第三个危机。
From chapter one, we look at the third crisis.
第三个危机在哪里呢？
Where is the third crisis?
请看十七节到二十节。
Verse 17 to verse 20.
来，一、二、三，他本来列在我们数目中，并且在使徒的自任上得了一份。这人用他作恶的工价买了一块田，以后身子扑倒，肚腹崩裂，肠子都流出来。住在耶路撒冷的众人都知道这事，所以按着他们哪里的话。给那块田起名叫雅各大马，就是雪田的意思。因为诗篇上写作说，愿他的住处变为荒场，无人在内居住。又说，愿别人得他的职分。这里的危机啊，就叫做领导层的危机，领导层的危机。
This crisis is entitled the crisis of the management.
这里我们看到犹大哈上吊自杀了嘛，而且死得很惨，肠子也破裂流出来。
You can see that Judas hung himself and died a very gory death.
按犹大是谁？犹大不是普通人啊，不是普通信徒啊。
Who is Judas? He is no ordinary disciple.
他是十二个使徒，是主耶稣特别拣选十二个使徒的其中一个使徒呀，这很。
He was one of the 12 disciples whom the Lord Jesus handpicked.
是主耶稣重要的工人啊，是主耶稣连夜拣选的，是带领教会的使徒来的。
It is one of the most important workers of the Lord Jesus, whom the Lord Jesus prayed day and night for.
我看到哦，这里的危机，领导层的危机是什么？领导层的危机是什么
？So why is this crisis of management?
领导层的一个很大的危机是撒旦会进入到领导层，进入到他们的那个圈子里面去。迷惑他们，去影响他们，哦，去破坏他们。
This great crisis of the management level is that the devil will enter into the management level to confuse them, tempt them, and also affect them.
这个我们常常忽略掉这个问题。
This is one question that we always
我们常常说啊，因为领导者好像啊，这个传道他有个性啊，他的脾气是这样啦、啊，啊，是他的脾气啦、啊，啊，是他的灵修啦、啊，啊，那个长子那个长老啊，他是很软弱啦、啊，啊，他是不敢讲话啦、啊。我们都把危机 推到他们个人的个性、个人的表现上去。
And very often, we neglected this crisis in the management level by saying that all these are just the traits of his personality of the specific individual, and there should be no problem about that.
但这个不是很大的问题，这个是最多是个人的软弱、个人的个性问题，我们都可以体谅，我们也可以包容、可以接纳的、可以明白的，这个不是很大问题。
So I reckon that this should be no major problem because we can appreciate and we can accept his personality.
领导层真正的危机就是撒旦进入他们里面去，然后去破坏他们、迷惑他们。
The greatest crisis.
最大的危机在这里。
The greatest crisis at the management level is that the devil had had invaded them to tempt them and to also destroy them.
犹大他是怎么样出卖耶稣的
？How did Judas betray the Lord Jesus？
除了他是圣经也有说他是贪爱钱财了，也有这样的记录了。
Of course, the Bible had also recorded that he had greed for money.
但是当他真正出卖耶稣的时候，真正把耶稣决定要卖耶稣的时候，圣经说是魔鬼进入他的心里面去。魔鬼进入他的心里面去，他就决定就做出来了，就不是贪爱钱财了，就不只是贪爱钱财，是出卖耶稣了。
In the very moment,
耶稣去上面耶稣了。
When Judas was about to betray Jesus, the Bible had recorded that the devil entered into his heart, entered into him before he finally betrayed the Lord Jesus.
其实主耶稣也有提醒我们，有讲过这篇道理。
In fact, the Lord Jesus had also reminded us with a sermon.
撒旦要会进入领导层去，一定会进入里面。
That Satan will definitely enter into the management level.
比如说我们总会嘛，总会是我们全国最高的组织嘛，撒旦就会进入总会里面去。
For example, at the General Assembly, the highest leadership level of the church, this is also where the devil will enter.
请注意哦，不是说进入教会哦，是进入领导层那个总会里面的领导层里面去哦。
Take note that it's not just entering into the church, but also to the leadership level of the church.
地方教会的领导就是执务会嘛，哦，长执会嘛。那么撒旦也会进入长执会 CMC 里面去，那个叫做领导层，会进入里面去。
The management level or the leadership level of the local church can also refer to the CMC, the committee members of the church.
那个是主耶稣很早就提醒我们的，然后撒旦会进来啊，会进入这些地方、这些领导的地方去啊。
On this matter, the Lord Jesus had already prophesied and warned us about this.
你不相信吗？你不相信？你看这个《路加福音》书二十二章。
If you don't believe, take a look at Gospel of Luke chapter 22.
路加福音书二十二章，我们来读三十一节到三十四节。
Luke 22 verses 31 to 34.
来，一二三，主又说：“西门，西门。”撒旦想要得着你们哦，好帅你们像摔麦子一样，但我已经为你祈求，叫你不至于失了信心。你回头以后要坚固你的弟兄。彼得说：“主啊，我就是同你下监、同你受死，也是甘心的。”耶稣说：“彼得，我告诉你，今日鸡还没叫。”你要三次说不认得我，主耶稣啊，很早就提醒门徒，撒旦哦，要进入你们当中去迷惑你们，去破坏你们。
The Lord Jesus had already made prior warning, very earlier on, that Satan would be entering, into them to destroy them.
当时的你们就是指十二个使徒呀。这是最高的领导，是主耶稣最重要的工人，最高的领导人。
And this you refers to the higher leadership level, the disciples.
就看谁被魔鬼迷惑，就看谁骄傲，看谁有问题，魔鬼就去附在他身上，或者是迷惑他了，种种方法，让他到最后就是在那边搞破坏了，甚至出卖耶稣了。
Satan has always kept a very watchful eye in terms of the management level, the leadership level, the disciples and apostles as to who will become proud and who will become greedy, and they will be the first targets for Satan.
或者这个已经被迷惑的，或者被附身的这个工人哦，来逼迫抵挡其他中心的工人，也有也很大的可能是这样子。
There's also a high possibility that that a worker of God been tempted to resist the church.
那主耶稣有讲出魔鬼进入领导层的一个工作的方法，魔鬼的方法，他的方式是什么？他用什么方式去就领导层去迷惑？耶稣有讲出一个方法，魔鬼的方法。
The Lord Jesus also pointed out a method that the devil would use to confuse and tempt the management.
这个比喻就已经说出了魔鬼是用这个方法来破坏领导层，这个比喻。
And this is also the parable that the Lord Jesus used in the way, the method that the devil would use to destroy the church.
耶稣说魔鬼好像什么？
What did the Lord
Jesus say? 好像摔麦子，这样把我们摔麦子，把我们摔出去，摔麦子，摔麦子。
That Satan will sift them as wheat.
哎，你有看过人家筛麦子吗？
Have you seen how people sift wheat?
筛麦子呢，就把你放在簸箕那边，然后一直转，一直转，一直转，转转转，一天到晚在给你转，你一天到晚在那边转转转，走不出来的。你一整天在那边打转打转，你走不出来的。转到你自己头晕晕，头昏脑胀，头晕懵啊，都不乐不乐气了。
When the farmers sift wheat using a basket, and there will be a turning around, twisting around until all the wheat are in a state of going blur.
对，我们今天不断的开会，开会一直打转，一直打转，一直开会又开会了又开会，开会了又开会，一直打转，就在那边打转而已。这个就是筛麦子啊。
It's almost like
筛麦子呀。
We going in and out of meetings again and again, like we have been sifted in a wheat basket, and we are all going dizzy.
然后他转了还不够，他会抛上来，把这样那个把那些东西在簸箕那边那样丢上来，这样丢上就是抛上来，然后跌下来了，又再抛上去，又跌下来，又再抛上去，给你摇啊，一直摇啊，一直摇你。
Not only will the farmer or spin you in the basket, but he will also throw you up and down, and until you are feeling
up and down, up and down, 对 up and down, 对，翻译的对了。不然就是在那边打转了，在转了，一直在转了。
Otherwise, you are spinning in the basket.
我一直在想哦，主耶稣为什么突然间说用这个比喻，用这个说法来告诉我们？我一直在想这个问题。原来是这样，所以说原来魔鬼就是用这样的方法，在我们领导人里面搞我们呢、啊，搞我们，不断的搞我们。
I was wondering why the Lord Jesus used this analogy to describe how the devil, how Satan will tempt us. It is also the same way that Satan will be confusing us. Likewise.
这个是领导层的危机啊！耶稣也说，确实是这样，他会进入领导层里面。
This is a crisis of the leadership and the management level.
如果他一个信徒他被迷惑，那破坏力没有这么强，最多那个信徒那一两个人离开教会，没有这么强。
If there was only one individual, a member who was confused and tempted, and the impact would not be so great.
如果领导层、长老或者传道或者执事、负责人他被迷惑，他的破坏力非常非常的可怕，非常非常的大。
But if any members of the committee level, the leadership level, the ministry level, be tempted, and the impact and the disruption will be great.
我们不用讲很远啊，我们讲自己马来西亚就是这样啊。
You don't have to talk too far. We can just talk about Malaysia, the Malaysian GA.
吉隆坡庇护教会是怎样离开我们的？难道是那些信徒带领离开的吗？那简直就是长老执事，就是那些执事、那些负责人带领离开的呀。你以为是信徒带领离开吗
？Do you really think that it was the members of the Pure TJC that caused the branching out,
还有日本教会啊
，and also the Japanese the TJC
整个教会没有掉了，整个教会没有掉，还甚至两个信徒也没有教会好机会。
The Japan TJC had a complete downfall, and there were only a few members left.
那个是传道来的
，those were preachers who caused.
大家听他的话，他就跟从他的，他一变质，大家也是跟着他走啊。
Everyone listened to them and follow them. As soon as they deteriorate and change, everyone will follow suit.
中国的事件啊，中国的教会好多好多啊，都是领导人带领离开教会，离开真教会。
There are also a lot of such cases that happen in China where the leadership level deteriorated and went astray, bringing along all the sheep.
当了传， 台湾教会也有这样的事情啊。
Such cases also happen in Taiwan.
所以魔啊，我们教会的第三个位，就从使徒行看的第三个位是领导层的危机很严重。
So the third crisis that we can see from Acts of the Apostles is on the level of the management and the leadership, which can be very, very severe.
有一次有一个信徒在为领导者，在为一个传道工人祷告了，为一个传道工人祷告。
There was a member, a believer, who prayed for a preacher.
那个传道是世界有名的，非常有恩赐、有能力的传道。
And this preacher was one who was very gifted and very popular on a global level.
突然间魔鬼显现了，笑他。
And suddenly, the devil appeared to mock at him.
他正在祷告啊，魔鬼显现笑他。
This believer was in the middle of a prayer and the devil appeared to mock at him.
他跟他说，你不用为这个人祷告了。
The devil told him, you don't have to pray for this person anymore.
这个祷告的信徒责问魔鬼，为什么？他是我们的传道，我当然要为他祷告呀。
And this member rebuked the devil that he is our preacher. I have to pray for him.
魔鬼说他已经是我的人。
The devil said to him that this preacher is already mine.
你听好吗？你听清楚了没有
？Do you hear this?
这个信徒为这个传道祷告。魔鬼说：“你不用为他祷告了，因为这个人，这个传道已经属于他。这个传道是他的人，是魔鬼的人，是属于撒旦的人啊。”
This believer was
很严重的事情啊。
Was interceding, was praying for this preacher, and the devil appeared to tell him that this preacher now is now belongs to the devil.
当然，魔鬼这样讲，我们也不能够这样就相信了。可能他是陷害那个传道呢？那个传道是很忠心的，他随便这样讲。我们也不能随便相信哦，特别是魔鬼讲的话呀。
But of course, we cannot simply believe in the words of the devil just from this accusation alone.
但是后来哦，经过几年哦，不是几个月哦，几年事情爆发出来，公布出来，才知道，之前几年前他就已经属于撒旦的人，他就已经在做恶事，在犯罪了，真的是属于撒旦，真的是撒旦的人来。
And subsequently, what happened was after a few years, not a few months, but a few years, something finally broke out.
还没有公布，还没有发，没有没有没有爆发出来的时候，大家都哇传道啊，神跟他同在啊，祷告得圣灵多少人啊，哇看异象多少人啊，办圣餐啊，感动啊，流泪啊，这个是什么东西啊？这到底是什么东西啊？
Before the final,
称赞他，大家就荣耀他呀。
The final news broke out or about a certain announcement about him took place a few years ago. He was already, it was already taken by the devil and having sinned, but in the middle of that, he still performed a lot of divine work.
这个是灵界的问题。
That is a problem with the spiritual realm.
对，我们就非常小心，非常留意哦，特别是长老。长老是监督教会的。当长老在教会，在末世，现在是末世的真耶稣教会。当长老的一定要非常非常的 sensitive 来注意这些灵界的问题。
And of course,
来注意这些领导层。
This is something that we must all be very sensitive about, especially the elders of the church should really pay close attention to this.
因为这个是他们的责任啊，是监督教会哦。我们传道没有力量讲话呀。
Because
我也不是长老啊，要怎么样讲话？人家都不甩你啊，那管你这么多。
Have the duty and the responsibility to oversee the church, and they have the power to speak up for this matter.
所以教会为什么安利你们成为长老？为什么？你们的责任是什么？你们要紧张的是什么？你们要看住的是什么
？This is the reason why the church has anointed you as the elder of the church. This is also what you should be really concerned about.
我是说，我们是很伤心的。我们不是批评人啊，我们是很悲伤的。
I'm not trying to criticize, but I'm feeling very sad about this.
其实这个时候就是长老要出生，长老要做的工作，监督教会，特别监督领导层，监督长老、执事、传道人、工人。
In many occasions,
他们是带领教会的嘛。
In many occasions, that the elders should be taking a step up to lead the church and to resolve issues.
也有很多同工也好，长子也好。前辈们也好，说你要看住这些工人啊，你要看住某某人啊，你要看住我怎样看啊，他的地位比我高啊，他讲话比我大声啊，都没有人要理我呀。
some coworkers requested that I be taking care and also monitoring certain other individuals, and I was very I was feeling very helpless because I have no power to do so.
他们有一群人，一群工，一群同工 support 做的，你怎样讲？你在讲人家说你嫉妒，你在讲人家说你怎么样怎么样骄傲，所以我们的痛苦在这里，我们的十字架在这里，十字架。
When these workers that we have to monitor closely have a huge following behind them, and it is really hard for us to raise our voices or point their issues. But this is the work supposedly taken by the elders. So after this sermon, the elders of the church should be
getting a lot of pressure. 都能够悔改，都能够真正的爱教会、爱灵魂、爱主耶稣的教会、爱主耶稣的工人。
It is also my wish that all the elders who have listened to this sermon would really return to loving the Lord Jesus, with a more sensitivity towards these issues.
我的意思说，不要再做所谓的好人了，所谓的哇，大家都很好，不要再这种，在末日真耶稣教里不要再做这种人了。
My meaning is, there's no need for you to put up the good cop look there in the end times, the true Jesus church will need more stern voices.
圣经早都预言，早都这样发生过多少次。凡事要跟从主的，要坚持真理、真诚、公义、圣洁的，一定被人恨，一定被人家排斥。那你还要做好人，那什么意思啊？做好人，不用做这些工作了。
The Bible has already prophesied that in the end times, people will hate the sound truth and doctrine. And this is a time when people will hate you for that. If you are playing the good cop, and you will never be able to face the real issues.
当然我的意思不是叫你乱去骂人啊，什么人都去讲，不是，当然不是这样。我们有智慧嘛，我们有圣灵在我们心中嘛。
I definitely do not expect that you go around screaming and shouting at people, and we have the wisdom from the Holy Spirit not to do that.
因为有一些工人已经很明显了，已经太明显，甚至连教会都拒绝他了，已经想要写信了或者要做什么了。我们这时候真的是要好好的去解决。Because
there are many.
我说对付这个地步呢，那个是再这样下去，教会会被魔鬼留下地步，被魔鬼借助这些。 这些工人啊，搞到教会很痛苦，甚至是不能发展，甚至不能荣耀神，甚至分裂掉啊！传道人也没有办法在一起工作呀，没有办法。There
are many instances where the workers are already showing signs of a resistance to God, and yet we are playing the good cop, and finally we will be ending up in a lot more disruption and dissension, divisions in the church.
有时我们就只好交托给主，我们就说交托给主。
And more often than not, we can only say that we hand this over to the Lord God.
如果你尽了责任，尽了责任，真的有去解决，但解决不到，感谢神，因为你尽了责任，交托给主，把这件事交托给主，那是正确的，我是支持的，也是觉得应该是这样做的。
But I can only support that if you have already played your part and done your role with all you can, and yet this case has not been resolved, and then we thank the Lord because we have tried our best.
我们既然讲危机，你就要讲解决危机嘛，这个就是解决危机啊。If
you want to talk about a crisis, we have to also talk about a crisis resolution. This is the way that we resolve this crisis.
这个是我们从使徒行传看教会危机，看到现在的情况，真的是这样。当初也是这样，当时的使徒教会也是这样，现在也仍然是这样。This
is also the crisis that we can see from Acts of the Apostles, which happened in the apostolic era. The same crisis will also take place in today's context.
如果你要更清楚使徒时代危机，你看起初那个去教会，你看到都会发抖啊，看到都会怎么可能会这样啊，在教会里面多么的糟糕，多么的严重啊，那些领导人。
If you want to have a deeper insights into what happened in the apostolic era, you can also refer to the seven churches in the book of Revelation, and you will tremble at looking at the state of these churches.
我们教会正在发生做领导层的危机，大家可能没有这么感受到，我感受很深。Probably
you don't observe the crisis at the management or the leadership level of the church today, and it is also not a it is also not proper for me to reveal it, but we are going through this stage.
所以在传道的讲道当中，勉励当中，常常说要为耶路撒冷求平安，常常要为耶路撒冷来祷告，要爱这个教会，要爱神的家。那个爱不是做烂好人，那个爱是爱真理，爱那个圣洁，爱那个教会里面的公义，那真是爱教会。
What I must encourage all of us to do is to love the church more, to pray more, and to also love what is just, what is holy, and what is righteous.
那今天我们大概就讲到这个第三个危机吧。
We will conclude with the third crisis here.
下一次我们讲第四个危机，第一章里面的第四个危机。
The next time we will share on the fourth crisis in chapter one.
愿我们凭着带着一种很谦卑的心，来从使徒行传。神的圣经的记录当中描写的一些事件当中，我们真正的得到造就，得到帮助，来不断检讨我们今日的教
会。May we all, after studying these actually apostles in the crisis of the church, we are able to continue to improve ourselves, grow ourselves, and spiritually nurture ourselves on these matters.
好，我们一起来唱赞美诗。
You sing hymn.
162首。
162。
162首主负我重担。
162 singing I go.
1, 2, 3。紧握头靠耶稣脚前，躲起苦难最轻，十字架下无限恩典，我比梦主垂怜，欢喜唱诗赞美救主，哈利路亚，哈利路亚，靠主天天背负重担，在世路上直到天降。May